Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, I thought I would look at one of the real jewels of the sky that is probably one of the best objects to view with a telescope. It's going to help to have a shorter focal length and a larger apparent field of view with a longer focal length eyepiece, so you get the maximum field of view possible to be able to see it. If not, you could use binoculars as well, or look at two parts of it individually. And by that, you may have figured out that we are going to be looking for the double cluster in Perseus. And this is, there's actually two different ways to be able to find it, because number one, some people have red dot finders on their telescopes and telrads. Those are the finders that really don't have any magnification to them. They're just magnify the sky at exactly what you see with your eye. So it's just a one power type thing. The other way to do it is by star hopping, but I really think that we can do a lot of this one fairly easily by estimating, and I do that fairly regularly, so I'm going to show you how to do that. The first thing we need to do is find where Perseus is. If you don't know where he is, look towards the north like this, and I bring up some of the constellation lines. We have the M shape of Cassiopeia right now, because Cassiopeia is over Polaris right here, directly towards the north. You can see how it's opposite where the Big Dipper is. The Big Dipper is really low in the sky, where I'm at 40 degrees north latitude. If you're even further south from there, it's not visible at all. If you're north of me, it's going to be a little higher, but it's still on the horizon, not easy to see. So Cassiopeia is right up here towards the north. This is about, two or three hours or so after sunset, so pretty easy to find this set of stars. They're mostly second magnitude stars. You can start from this middle one and go out to the right towards the upper point of the M, and then just project that out. And I'm going to use the measuring tool here to kind of show that. You can project it out, and boom, you practically run into about 25 degrees later, which is about this far. You're going to run into the brightest star in Perseus right here, Alpha Persei, which is also known as Mirfak. And there's a lovely cluster actually right around there. So if you happen to have binoculars, do look in that direction at that particular star. But the other way to be able to find Perseus, and I'm going to give you a little bit more a backed up view kind of the entire night sky here, because this is a lot of overhead stuff. You can see how on the azimuthal grid, we're looking pretty much at the zenith right here, at least from my latitude. So we've got the Great Square of Pegasus. Pegasus' nose kind of goes up this direction. Andromeda comes this way, kind of under where, well, actually over where Cassiopeia is at. And this is how I used to find Perseus fairly easily, is I would just do a kind of a continual 15-degree hop. You can go from here to here, and these are the legs or underbelly of Pegasus, and this is going to be the head then of Andromeda, Alpha Rats. You skip to Mirac, Beta Andromedae, to Almac, Gamma Andromedae, and then go another about 15 or 20 degrees, kind of in that same direction, and there is Mirfak in Perseus. Pretty easy to find, right? So as we zoom in on this area towards, it's going to be the northeast-ish, we can see how we've got some fairly bright stars that are in this area. We've got Algol, which is kind of that winking star that about every 2 days or so has an eclipsing star that makes it dip down in brightness. But we're going to go this direction, kind of towards where Cassiopeia is at. And I can practically guess where the double cluster is. I mean, I literally didn't even try. I just pointed right there, because this is almost exactly halfway in between these two stars. So from right here to here is about 15 degrees. You can see that's 15 and 0 minutes. So the double cluster right there is 7 degrees or so. And if you go even 7.5, you're still going to have that in the same field of view. So what you're going to look for is Mirfak at second magnitude right there, actually 1.75. So just a tad brighter than second magnitude. And then here, with Gamma Cassiopeiae, which is 2.2 magnitude, and Delta Cassiopeiae, which is 2.7 magnitude. And then this star right here is your faintest one of the four that you're going to want to look at. This is Gamma Persei, and it is 2.9 magnitude. So really getting close to third magnitude, but still visible for really most anywhere. I can still see this one even at the Adler Planetarium near downtown Chicago. If you're in the loop of Chicago, you won't be able to see it. But out there by the lake, it is still visible. You just have to look pretty hard for it. Look for Cassiopeia first. And then if you have a zero or one power finder, I guess is the appropriate way to say that, literally just aim halfway in between these two things, or these two stars here and here, and you're going to wind up at the double cluster. The other way to do it is you can star hop. If you're going to do that, I think that going from Cassiopeia gives you a little bit more direct line, because if you go from Murfak here this way, you miss it, kind of. It doesn't quite go where you need it to go, whereas if you follow the stars from Cassiopeia, you're pretty much dead on. And then as soon as this star gets out of the field of view, you just keep going, and you may even be able to see the double cluster. It's actually that bright. And then when we zoom in on that area, we find that we have a pretty dense field of stars, and these are really this is a large area that we're talking about here. When we go across that, that's 2 degrees that I'm showing right there. So unless your telescope can get 2 degrees, you may just want to kind of focus in on a 1 degree field and get one cluster at a time, and then swoop over to the other side and then get the other cluster the rest of the time, because it is really quite a sight to see. It's very wide across, despite how far it is. It's 7,500 light years away. That light traveled a long time to get to your eyes. The two clusters have around 3,000 to 4,000 solar masses each. And actually the halo of stars around it, which I'm not sure if you can really kind of see on Stellarium here. But there's actually a total of 20,000 solar masses that you're looking at if you're looking at both of these things at the same time. So that's a pretty impressive sight. And it's really a great outreach object to share with people too. So if you're going out and you're showing people things in the night sky, the double cluster is definitely one to do, because people will see a lot of stars, and for a lot of people, you'll kind of get that wow moment with them when you provide them that particular view of the night sky. So that is all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.